team. Channing Frye, who won a title with LeBron in Cleveland, said this: I don't know if they truly understand what it's like to play with him, because there is no room for mistakes, because in all actuality, he could do it himself. He could lead a team to 40 wins by himself. I think for all of them, they're going to have a reality check, not only them, but the people around them. There's going to say not a growing period, but a humility. All right, CC, I'll start with you. Is Channing Frye right about this, about LeBron James?
The reason why I know this to be true is just based on my own experience of playing with seven guys in Pro Football Hall of Fame, and also the athletic career of my brother, seeing the players that he played with as a senior. They recruited a kid from Chicago by the name of Isaiah Thomas. And spending time in the gym with Isaiah when he was in high school, I was like, man, I've never seen a basketball player like that. Subsequently, go 2 years forward, my brother gets drafted by the Lakers. They have a guy named Captain Kareem, and they have another guy by the name of Irvin Magic Johnson. So it is a shock, even to good, accomplished players, when you play with the best of the best. Like, I thought I was in great shape until I was a teammate of Herschel Walker, and I realized he actually was doing 10,000 sit-ups and push-ups a day, running 3 miles before practice in the morning, only eating one meal a day. Roger Craig told me I'd never ever be as good as Jerry Rice because I don't train as well as him. I don't run as much as him. I'm not committed to the game. So it is alarming. You are shocked because you think, and you've been to big programs, you've been taught, and you think that you work hard. When you see the best of the best that have done it, it is amazing, because you question, man, do I really want to win?
What about when you got there, what you saw from Reggie White?
Oh.
I mean, before, people think of you as being one of the guys we're talking about here, but you weren't Chris Carter we know now when you first get to Philly.
No.
Reggie White was Reggie White.
No, and the best players in the NFL, he would man-toss them. Two or three people over. I had never seen anything like it before. And just to be able to talk to him and how he developed some of his overall strength. So yes, you are shocked when you are around the greatest of the great, and even though you are a great or accomplished player.
And in football, it's one thing, but football, there's more guys, and everyone has a specific job to do, and while it runs together, I think the better comparisons you were bringing up are what your brother Butch dealt with, because in basketball, Isaiah could only do the things Isaiah needed to do as a freshman at IU if Butch was doing his part. Like, there's an element of that there that I think Channing's talking about.
What I was really shocked about was not only the things that they practiced, but all the things that they could do that they hadn't even done in the game. So what Shannon's talking about is they're going to be amazed at his overall conditioning. Like, you think the videos, like, people try to make fun of the videos, but when you have the greatest player in the world doing those workouts 3 hours before you go to practice, before you go every night to play, like, when you see him sacrificing in what he does for his body, like, it's going...
What effect does that have on those players? Because either they're going to step up and try to even come close to what he's doing, or it almost blankets and overshadows, saying, well, I don't have to do that. LeBron's going to do it.
And
I think that's a little bit of what Channing was talking about.
Well, and there's a third option, which is they can't handle it. Jordan Clarkson couldn't. Jordan Clarkson was a fine little player for the Lakers. Gave you about 16 a game, did his thing, took some bad shots, but whatever. He got to the Cavs, and all of a sudden, oh, okay. So we got a basketball supercomputer running this basketball team. And every shot that I take that is, you watch, you say, was that inefficient? LeBron knows just how inefficient it was, and he knows where the better pass was, because there's a great story about LeBron and the analytics team discussed once. They developed a computer program that basically showed the ideal positioning for players on offensive and defensive sides of the ball, and then they overlaid actual games, see where guys would be. And LeBron was the only player in the league not only to be exactly where he was supposed to be, but to get there faster than the ghosts, faster than the program said the fastest player could get to. That's how his brain works. Some of these guys will thrive because of it. I think for Lonzo, this will be great, because I think Lonzo has that type of brain. I think for some of these other guys, and we won't know who they are until they get there, I think Lance could be tough for Lance. He's not a young player. But I think the style that Lance plays, the kind of inefficient, herky-jerky, I feel like I got the hot hand, that can really irk a player who always knows what the right play is, and through his own detriment publicly, through the own noise he's going to have on television, will always make the right play, even if it means I'm not taking the shot. Like, those are the guys that can struggle to play with LeBron.
The guys, the athletes that have taken more of a cerebral approach to their craft are the ones seemingly that are the most successful. We saw it in that Tom versus Time, where Tom Brady sits and he looks at the analytics and he goes back over the tape and he goes inch by inch where he should be and what he should do and what he should have done. And it seems like that's almost an innate quality that LeBron James has. And not a knock on these other players, but a lot of them have just been using their physicality, right? Just going out and muscling through basketball because they've been so talented through the years.
Yeah,
and it's going to be a little bit of a jarring sort of halt to see how the game is played from a different perspective.
It's always playing with, I know players personally, Scottie Pippen was shocked with Michael Jordan's expectations. Ron Harper was already an all-star. He was shocked. Michael Jordan told him, man, you're going to be meeting in my house at 6 in the morning. So, yeah, these are just young players. When you're around greatness, it's not as if you see it every day. That's why it's called greatness. And when you see it, you should be able to embrace it. We have no clue which players are going to embrace it. We have no clue which players and their group that handles them, how they're going to handle it. So I'm not going to sit here and guess. I know what LeBron has is real. And I've been to practices, I've been to many, many games, and through the examples of other great basketball players. Isaiah Thomas, little Isaiah Thomas, the real Isaiah Thomas, not the one playing now. The pressure that he put on the Pistons at 6 foot, he became the bad boys. Not because they got Lambeer or these other players Rodman, it was because his attitude, and great players request. They request, they make demands on you every single day to be able to get better. And that's the pressure that these young Lakers, and if they are who I think they are, I think that they will enjoy it because it is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. I think Ingram, I think Kuzma, I think they will enjoy it because they will be pushed.
I think that's a very good point. All right, coming up, can Drew Brees lead the Saints to the Super Bowl and then ride off into the sunset? It's a beautiful fairy tale. It's just a tease, though. That's next on First Things First.
I think someone else probably said.